Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So previously we have seen that what is crystal oscillator, how it works, and we have also seen the important parameters of the crystal oscillator which needs to be considered while selecting the crystal for the specific application. So in this video, we will see the different types of crystal oscillators which are used commercially for the different applications. And during the video, we will also see the basic working principle of the each type of crystal oscillator. So we have seen that these crystal oscillators uses a piezoelectric effect of the quartz crystal to generate the precise electrical signal of the particular frequency. So depending on the required tunability, the temperature stability and the aging rate, the different types of crystal oscillators are used in the various applications. So these are the four different types of crystal oscillators which are used commercially for the different applications. So first, let us understand why such different crystal oscillator exist. So the thing is, these crystal oscillators are inherently very stable compared to the any other oscillators, and they used to produce accurate frequency. But there are certain factors which can change the output frequency of the crystal oscillators. And the one of them is the aging of the crystal. So typically with the aging, the crystal oscillator frequency can change by plus minus 1 ppm to 5 ppm over 1 year, where this ppm stands for parts per million. So for example, for a 12 MHz crystal oscillator, if the aging rate is plus minus 5 ppm over 1 year, then after the 5 years, its frequency will change by 300 MHz. And accordingly, these are the maximum and the minimum possible oscillation frequencies. So for some applications, this change in the frequency may not make much difference. But if you see the certain applications, then they demand the high level of stability, like the precise instrumentation, the space and the military applications. So typically, to fine-tune the frequency due to aging, some crystal oscillators used to have a provision to tune the frequency, so that the error introduced in the frequency due to aging can be compensated. So typically, in these crystal oscillators, there is an additional trimmer capacitor to fine-tune the frequency. That means the change in the frequency due to the aging of the crystal oscillator can be compensated with the help of these trimmer capacitors. But apart from that, the crystal oscillator frequency can also change due to the temperature. And in the normal crystal oscillators, if you see the drift in the crystal oscillator frequency due to the temperature, then it is substantial compared to the aging. So in some applications, where a high level of stability is required, such drift in the frequency due to temperature is not acceptable. So in such applications, where such high level of frequency stability is required over the operating temperature range, these different types of crystal oscillators can be used. So if you see the one such crystal oscillator, then it is the temperature compensated crystal oscillator, and commonly it is known as the TCXO. So typically, over the operating temperature range of 0 to 50 degrees Celsius, if you see the temperature stability of such crystal oscillators, then it is in the range of plus minus 0.2 ppm to 2 ppm. So for example, if the crystal frequency is 1 MHz, then over the operating temperature range, the change in the frequency can be as low as 0.2 Hz, or at the max, it can be up to 2 Hz. So as you can see from these numbers, these temperature compensated crystal oscillators provides much more stability compared to the normal crystal oscillators. And if you see the typical aging rate of these crystal oscillators, then it is in the range of plus minus 0.5 ppm to 2 ppm per year. So now, let us see the typical working principle of this crystal oscillator. So this temperature compensated crystal oscillator consists of the temperature sensor, and typically, a thermistor is used as a temperature sensor. Now, as you know, this thermistor can have either negative temperature coefficient or the positive temperature coefficient. So, in case of the negative temperature coefficient thermistor, as the temperature increases, then the resistance of the thermistor reduces. On the other end, in case of the positive temperature coefficient thermistor, as the temperature increases, then the resistance of the thermistor also increases. So, first, the thermistor output is converted into the voltage, and it is very easy to do that. So what you can do, you can design a voltage divider circuit with the help of the thermistor. So in this voltage divider circuit, one of the resistor can be a fixed value resistor, while the other resistor can be a thermistor. And this voltage divider can be biased with the fixed reference voltage. So now, as the temperature of the thermistor changes, then the resistance of the thermistor also changes. And accordingly, the voltage which will appear across the thermistor will also change. And in this way, we can get the output voltage that is proportional to temperature. So with the help of the difference amplifier circuit, this output voltage of the thermistor is compared with some fixed reference voltage. And this circuit is designed in a such a way that at the calibrated temperature, the output of this difference amplifier provides the fixed output. So as the temperature changes, then the output of the difference amplifier will also change linearly. So this control voltage of the difference amplifier is then given to the varector diode of the crystal oscillator. So as you know, in the varector diode, the capacitance of the diode changes according to voltage. So here, this varector diode acts as a tunable load capacitor for this crystal. So here, depending on the change in the temperature, the control voltage which is applied to the varector diode is changed in a such a way that the crystal oscillator frequency remains almost constant. So typically, if you see the change in the crystal oscillator frequency with the temperature, then it is not linear. And as you can see, this change in the frequency of the crystal oscillator with the temperature has a polynomial relationship. That means here, we cannot directly apply the difference amplifier output to the varector diode. So here, to correct the change in the frequency due to temperature, here we need a voltage polynomial for this varector diode, which has exactly opposite characteristic to this given polynomial. So here, after this difference amplifier, we also have the additional block for this polynomial generation, and it generates the required control voltage for this varector diode. So in this way, the temperature compensated crystal oscillator maintains the stable frequency at the output. So this type of crystal oscillators are widely used in many telecommunication applications, as well as they are also used in the IoT applications. And apart from that, they are also used in many consumer products where very stable clock source is required. Now, if you see the some applications, then they demand even higher temperature stability compared to these TCXOs. So in such applications, these oven controlled crystal oscillators are used. So as its name suggests, in this type of crystal oscillator, the temperature of the crystal is controlled with the help of the mini internal oven. So this oven controlled crystal oscillator provides a very good temperature stability. So we have seen that in the temperature controlled crystal oscillator, the temperature stability was in the ppm, that is parts per million. But here in this oven controlled crystal oscillators, the temperature stability is in the parts per billion. So this crystal oscillator provides the temperature stability in the range of 1 ppb to 100 ppb. And if you see their aging rate, then that is also very low. So as I said, in this oven controlled crystal oscillator, we have a mini oven inside the crystal oscillator module. So typically, a power transistor and the resistor is used as a heating element inside this mini oven. And here, the thermistor is used as a temperature sensor to monitor the temperature of this mini oven. So using the additional control circuit, this oven is maintained at the constant temperature. So here, this control circuit is mounted on this main PCB. And as you can see, on the other side of this oven, there is a crystal oscillator. And this entire module is enclosed within the insulated material, so that the internal temperature of the crystal will not get affected by the ambient temperature. So now, the question is, what should be the operating temperature of this oven? So typically, the oven is operated at the turning point of the crystal, where the slope of the temperature versus frequency curve is zero. And the reason for operating the oven at this point is that, even if there is a change in the temperature, the change in the frequency of the crystal will be minimum. Moreover, the operating point of the oven should be well above the operating range of this crystal oscillator. Because as I said, in the oven, the power transistors or the resistors are used as a heating element. So if the operating temperature of the oven is less than the ambient temperature, then it is not possible to maintain the oven at the fixed temperature. For example, if the operating temperature of the oven is 25 degrees Celsius and the ambient temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, then it is not possible to maintain the oven at the 25 degrees Celsius. and that is why this oven is operated well above the operating temperature range of this crystal oscillator, like at 60 or the 70 degrees Celsius. So this oven controlled crystal oscillators are used in the applications where very stable clock frequency is required. And that is why they are used in the precise instrumentation as well as in the broadcasting. Apart from that, they are also used in the high performance computing as well as in the military applications. But the disadvantage of this crystal oscillator is that they consume lot of power. And that is why they are not suitable for the battery operated systems. Moreover, they also have very high warm up time. Meaning that once the crystal oscillator is turned on, then this oven will take few minutes to reach to the set temperature. And after that only, we will get the desired frequency. Apart from that, if you see the cost of this OCXO, then they are much costlier compared to the other oscillators. And that is why they are used only in the specific applications. Now in some applications where even higher temperature stability is required, so in such applications, these double oven controlled crystal oscillators are used. So this double oven controlled crystal oscillator is made by putting the OCOX in the another oven. So here, this outer oven acts as a buffer layer for the OCOX, and it prevents any change in the internal oven temperature due to the ambient temperature change. So this type of crystal oscillators are ultra stable and provides the highest temperature stability among the different crystal oscillators. And also, their aging rate is also very low. So this stability and the aging rate also depends on the crystal cut. So typically, the two types of crystals which are used in the oscillators, that is AT cut and the SC cut. So if you see the SC cut crystals, then they provide better stability compared to the AT cut crystals. So in this way, using the double oven structure as well as the SC cut crystals, it is possible to improve the stability of the crystal oscillator. But this arrangement consumes even more power than the OCOX, and also they are very much costly. So although this type of crystal oscillator provides a very good temperature stability, but because of their higher power consumption, they are not suitable for the battery operated devices. So to use such crystal oscillators in the battery operated devices, another version of the OCOX is used. And this version is known as the evacuated miniaturized crystal oscillator, or in short, it is known as the EMXO. So in this type of crystal oscillator, the crystal and the relevant electrical circuits are integrated in the single chip, and that electrical assembly is housed on top of the miniaturized oven, and then this entire assembly is vacuum sealed. So here, the vacuum inside the assembly provides the required insulation. And here, because of the miniaturization of the entire assembly, the overall volume that needs to be heated in the oven also reduces. And because of that, the power consumption of the overall assembly will also reduce. So this version of the crystal oscillator provides the temperature stability between the TCOX and the OCOX. Moreover, it consumes less power and it is suitable for the battery operated devices. And mainly, they are used in the telecommunication applications. So far, mainly we have seen three types of crystal oscillators, that is normal crystal oscillator, the temperature compensated crystal oscillator, and the oven controlled crystal oscillator. So now, let us see the last type of crystal oscillator, that is voltage controlled crystal oscillator. So this VCXO is similar to the voltage control oscillator, but it provides the better stability compared to the VCO. So if you see the voltage control oscillators or the VCO, then they have a wider tuning range compared to the VCXOs. But when it comes to the temperature stability, then this VCXO provides the better stability. So this voltage controlled crystal oscillators consist of a varector diode as a variable capacitor. So by changing the biasing voltage of this varector diode, it is possible to change the capacitance. And in this way, it is possible to tune the frequency of the oscillator from its nominal frequency. So for this VCXOs, the frequency range over which it is possible to change the oscillation frequency using the control voltage is known as the pulling range. And typically, it is mentioned in the ppm. So for the normal crystal oscillator, if you see the pulling range, then it is from plus minus 5 ppm to 10 ppm. But for this voltage control crystal oscillator, this pulling range varies from plus minus 10 ppm to 2000 ppm. So typically, this voltage control crystal oscillators with a higher pulling range have a lower stability. So while selecting the voltage control oscillator for the specific application, to get a good stability, one should not go beyond the required pulling range. So these voltage control crystal oscillators are used in many phase lock loop systems, and they are also used in many telecommunication applications. Apart from that, they are also used in many test and the measurement instruments where it is required to change the clock frequency. And apart from that, they are also used in many industrial control systems. So these are some of the applications of the VCXO. So I hope through this video you understood what are the different types of crystal oscillators, what is their working principle, and how they are used in the different commercial applications. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.